Welcome back to Good Day, Orlando. Wow, look at that. What a beautiful view this morning. Looking down on the city, beautiful. This gorgeous church with the buttresses. That's a little of my architect knowledge there. It's all I got for you. So, John, you'll have to take it or leave it.
You went architectural on us, Amy. Hey, a lot of people deciding to skip churches on Sunday, but that doesn't mean people are less religious. A new survey finds that only about 40% of Americans now attend worship services at least once a month. You get that 40% once a month. That's down about 10% from 3 decades ago. It's also the lowest levels on record. But Americans also say that they are now praying more than they have in the past. So that doesn't add up. Joining us this morning to talk about it is Chad Turnbull with Northland Church. Always good to see you. Appreciate you being here today. Okay, you've seen these numbers.
Yeah.
Fewer people going to church. More people say they're religious. What's going on here?
Yeah, I think in many ways, actually, this study is some encouraging news for the church.
How so?
Because while they have left the building, they have not left their faith. And I think it leads to a really interesting question and challenge for the church to begin to say, not how do we get these people back into the building, but rather how do we begin to reform in such a way that would allow us to equip them to live out their faith everywhere, every day, in a very vibrant way.
But I also read recently a record number of churches are shutting down, yet a church like yours, Northland, is booming. What are you guys doing to attract that many people while others simply aren't doing it?
I think certainly, you know, you could look at the resources that are available, the production, you know, that we put into services on a weekend. But I think it goes beyond that. I think it also connects to the way that churches make every effort to connect into people's everyday life. So making sure that their Monday through Saturday experience resonates with what they also experience on Sunday morning, and equipping them to live that out then through the rest of their week.
I know a lot of churches struggle with this. They want to have a traditional kind of a sermon, right? You have the piano, you have the traditional format. But like I always say, if we did the same kind of newscast we did in 1970, nobody would be watching us. Right. You have to reform and change with the times, right? Or is that wrong? Should it remain the way it used to be?
Well, I think the church has always been really good at and best suited when it is helping people engage with the transcendent, you know, engage with God, and engage with the sacred, and connect with other people and live out a shared identity of faith. What that looks like and the forms that takes has always had to change, and it's going to continue to change. And I think even mega churches today are having to look at, well, wait a second, how do we not just grow this thing bigger and bigger, but actually how do we equip people in ways that are smaller and smaller, helping them form spiritual families even that allow them to live that out and engage the transcendent and sacred in community.
I've also heard that if you don't get the kids, your church doesn't grow, because you need the kids to obviously grow the church in the future, but right. You need those young families.
Right.
Do you guys focus on that as much as we hear?
Yeah, absolutely. And I think that's one of the things that the church has done well when it's done it well is to really engage in programs and activities and in ways to help kids and young families. I mean, goodness, it's hard, you know, growing up having young kids and that old, you know, trying to drag them to church and fighting and kicking and screaming. Well, if you can do things that are tailored to children where they wake up and say, you know, I can't wait to get there, you know, that's
a
different thing.
Yeah, and kids and young people are different. We all know that. If there's not bells and whistles, they're not going to go anymore. I think we're seeing that, right?
Yeah, and at the same time, they're also looking for authentic engagement, especially as they get older. I mean, we see that in particular with millennials. Now, with young kids, you've got to have the things that are going to engage them, same as schools and all the different things that we're trying to do. But as they get older, I think they're looking for an authentic experience in addition to the programmatic pieces.
All right, Chad Turnbull over at Northland. Good to see you. Appreciate you being here.